Microsoft Defender Application Control changes the application security model from trust everything to trust nothing until it earns that trust. In this video, I'll demonstrate how application control works and how to deploy it. It's a sad fact that many users trust everything and usually perform minimal validations before opening things like email attachments. For example, I just got this email from a vendor. It looks like an invoice. The email address is correct, and I'm sure this person wouldn't send me anything bad. Wrong. I open the attachment and I quickly notice that something is wrong. I don't even know it yet, but I've just installed malware that's going to use my computer to mine coins for the attacker. Application control helps to block these types of attacks by restricting the applications, scripts, and installers that users can run. It helps you build a circle of trust containing approved applications. Anything not in that circle doesn't run. In this case, the Excel file I downloaded has an untrusted script in it. I'll try to open that file again, but this time with application control enabled. When I do, this is all I get. A pop-up telling me that application control has blocked the app. I guess I won't be mining coins today. Next, I'll describe how application control works. There are two approaches to blocking malicious apps: allow list and deny list. Deny list is an open door policy. You'll trust every app until it proves to be malicious, and then you add it to the deny list. The problem is scalability. You can't possibly keep up with the millions of malicious apps out there. On the other hand, allow list is a closed door policy. You'll trust nothing that isn't on your list. In this case, you're building a circle of trusted apps. As you might have guessed, application control is based on an allow list. You build a list of apps that are allowed to run, and it blocks everything else. Don't worry, application control has some clever ways to help you get started with little or no pain. For example, you can simply choose to trust all applications that have a good reputation, blocking everything else.
That reputation comes from the Microsoft Intelligent Security Graph. It uses artificial intelligence, machine learning, and other techniques to process trillions of signals. For example, it processes more than 630 billion authentications each month, and it scans 470 billion emails for malware and phishing attempts. The Intelligent Security Graph turns those signals into actionable threat intelligence, which in this case is reputation data. That represents a growing inventory of nearly 5 billion new and distinct malicious threats that are detected and added each month, which Microsoft products can then identify and can act on.
Microsoft Defender for Endpoint captures detailed information when application control blocks an application, installer, or script. That's useful as part of your alert investigations, but also to gain visibility into the apps that it's blocking. For example, take the attack I just tested. Here's what it looks like on my computer's timeline in Microsoft Defender Security Center. You see that application control blocked the malware because it wasn't allowed. Next, we'll see just how easy it is to enable and manage application control. In Microsoft Endpoint Manager, configuring application control is simple. The application control settings are in device configuration profiles. So I'll create a new profile and set the type to Endpoint Protection. Then select Microsoft Defender Application Control to configure it. First, I'll enforce Application Control Code Integrity Policies. Another option, particularly if you want to use Microsoft Defender for Endpoint to monitor the impact before enforcing it, would be to just audit application control. Next, I'll enable Trust Apps with Good Reputation. That expands our circle of trust to include apps that have good reputations in the Intelligent Security Graph, in addition to those that come with Windows or that employees install from the Microsoft Store. The last step is to assign the profile. Select Assignments and choose the groups you want to include. In this case, I'll include all my devices. You may need to create and deploy additional policies to meet your specific needs, but this will get you started using application control to block programs you don't trust. Application control can prevent malware from running on your organization's devices by creating a circle of trusted applications and blocking the rest. You can learn more about application control on Microsoft Docs.